Come on, Jorge. Come and help.
You can do it.
Valentina and Jorge are farmers. Right now, they can only access about 1 hectare of their land. The rest of it is located in the separatist region of Transnistria, only a stone throw from the village of Kocheri. They've been cut off from it since January, when the self-proclaimed authorities in Transnistria imposed a ban on Moldovan farmers.
Since 2006, it's now the third or fourth time that this is happening. It happened before that we didn't have access to our land and couldn't work it for 2 or 3 years. Imagine the difficulty of starting from scratch again.
Georgis and Valentina's children left Moldova years ago. They are on their own as they try to prepare the land for a full harvest, but they don't know how they will do it.
There is no hope. We're old now. All our children left. Why do you think they left? Because of this situation here.
That situation began more than 3 decades ago. Moldovan forces fought pro-Russian separatists in the early 1990s. Moscow has Russian troops stationed in Transnistria ever since, a de facto state. Not recognized internationally, but supported by Russia. Moldovans like Yuri and his comrade Valerio fought during that war. Now they are worried that things will get worse again.
For the population here, freedom of movement is prohibited, with the exception of the ferry. Moving goods across this region is forbidden as well, and so is freedom of expression.
This ferry is crucial. It lets Moldovans get around Transnistrian border controls. The Dniester River divides Moldova from the breakaway region, except for a few Moldovan enclaves. Yuri and Valerio say it's only a question of time for Russia to use Transnistria to attack Moldova.
People are concerned. From Putin, you can expect anything. Today, he can say one thing. Tomorrow, he can do another.
We don't have permission to film in the separatist-controlled Transnistrian region. Russian soldiers who are officially on a peacekeeping mission keep a watch. But there are pro-Russian voices in Moldovan-controlled enclaves too. Some here openly endorse Putin.
He will protect us, maybe increase our pensions, because we're getting little money here. We want to be with Russia. They help us.
Russian President Vladimir Putin has set plans for a long time for the roughly 200,000 people with Russian passports in Transnistria. Part of his foreign policy doctrine based on a so-called Russian world.
There are many Russian citizens in Transnistria. People there have their own concept of their future and their fate. This is nothing other than a display of democracy if we allow these people to do as they wish.
The Moldovan government, however, wants to steer Moldova towards the EU. They say Russia has been trying to destabilize Moldova, and they say the newly introduced customs for goods from Transnistria is necessary.
I'm not denying the fact that the economic situation in the Transnistrian region is bad. But Moldova is not the one to be blamed for that. It is not because of Ukraine. It's bad due to the consequences of Russia's aggression against Ukraine.
Georgi and Valentina say there is no real stability for them as long as the conflict with the separatists persists.
What can I do? I'm too old to plan anything for my future. We cannot plan anything. Our health isn't good. We have no strength left in our arms. We wait for our pension every month. It's all we have.
But no one here knows what a solution might look like for the people on both sides of the Dniester River, or what plans Moscow has for the region.